Welcome to the West Wing Week, your guide to everything that's happening at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. This week, the president happily kicked off the second annual science fair at the White House and continued to call for an all-hands-on-deck approach to educating our kids in the fields of math, science, technology, and engineering. He also spoke about putting our veterans back to work at Fire Station No. 5 in Arlington, announced a $25 billion agreement to help homeowners and hold big banks accountable, and unveiled yet another We Can't Wait initiative to encourage states to raise standards and reform schools. That's February 3rd to February 9th, or don't be bored,
make something. That's a great motto. Actually, I'm going to keep your card, just in case.
On Friday, the president visited Fire Station No. 5 in Arlington, Virginia, which is one of the first stations to respond to the 9/11 attack on the Pentagon. After a decade of war, the president announced new initiatives to put veterans back to work in his blueprint for an American economy that's built to last.
We need to make sure that as our troops return from battle, they can find a job when they get home. Congress should take the money that we're no longer spending on war, use half of it to pay down our debt, and use the rest to do some nation building here at home to improve the quality of life right here in the United States of America.
On Monday, the White House began preparations for its second annual science fair, which welcomes students and their exhibits, ranging from breakthrough research to new inventions. The student scientists and inventors were winners of a broad range of science, technology, engineering, and math competitions from all across America. On Tuesday, the White House Science Fair was in full swing, and the president spent nearly an hour reviewing the exhibits and talking to the students on the state floor of the White House. So without further ado, enjoy these highlights from one of the president's favorite days of the year.
Well, I've developed a system for detecting nuclear threats, and specifically in cargo containers, so...
What grade are you guys in?
Sixth.
You're in sixth grade? You guys are already inventing stuff? That's outstanding. This is great. Cotswold is a you say it's a fairly rare breed of sheep?
Yes.
So you guys are filing a patent on this thing
right
now. That's outstanding work.
Thank you.
We're really proud of you. Excellent. Is this a sample here?
Yeah.
Well, we're very proud of you.
Thank you.
Go cure cancer.
Thank you.
How far away are we, do you think, to the point where people actually have a prosthetic arm that they can completely control?
I designed the game.
You designed the game. Sheesh. When I decide to move my arm up, there's a certain pattern. And so essentially, you're then replicating the pattern.
Do I see a little light in
there? There is an LED light.
That's
there.
An LED light.
I have to go over and
down. There, you got him.
Secret Service really didn't want me bringing my nuclear reactor in here. they tried to hire me, so I don't know. It's a mixed message.
You're optimizing as the sun moves through the sky how much sunlight you're actually catching.
Yes.
Oh! So you got a patent, so nobody's gonna mess with you.
Yeah.
Smart stuff. You're a smart guy. All right. Keep it up. All right, good job.
The president then spoke on the importance of STEM education to the country's economic future.
I just spent some time checking out some of the projects that were brought here today, and I've got to say, this is fun. It's not every day that you have robots running all over your house. When you work and study and excel at what you're doing in math and science, when you compete in something like this, you're not just trying to win a prize today. You're getting America in shape to win the future.
On Thursday, the president was joined by Attorney General Eric Holder and HUD Secretary Sean Donovan to announce an historic $25 billion agreement that will hold big banks accountable and offer much-needed help for millions of homeowners without costing taxpayers a dime.
That's what today's settlement's all about, standing up for the American people, holding those who broke the law accountable, restoring confidence in our housing market and our financial sector, getting things moving, and we're going to keep on at it until everyone shares in America's comeback.
Later, the president appeared at a White House event with Education Secretary Arne Duncan and education leaders from 10 states that have agreed to implement bold reforms and raise education standards in exchange for greater flexibility from the burdensome mandates of the federal education law known as No Child Left Behind.
This is good news for our kids. It's good news for our country. The best ideas aren't going to just come from here in Washington. They're going to come from teachers and principals and parents. They're going to come from you. And our job is to harness those ideas to lift up best practices, to hold states and schools accountable for making them work.
And ending this West Wing week with a Viva Italia, the president welcomed Prime Minister Monti of Italy to the White House to discuss the comprehensive steps the Italian government is taking to restore market confidence, reinvigorate growth through structural reforms, and bring some stability to European financial markets. To find out more information on any of these topics or to see complete videos of these events, go to whitehouse.gov. And thanks again for checking out your West Wing week.
It's really cool, though.
Thanks.
How long did it take you to design it?
A couple months.
Uh-huh. So you want to be a game designer?
Maybe.
Yeah? Yeah, you're only fifth grade. You don't have to make up your mind now. You got time to decide.